So, itong next problem natin naman, madali lang kasi nakasolve na tayo ng cable problems. Yun nga lang, may bago dito sa tanong natin. Itong, how much additional load can the cable carry? Yan, medyo maganda kasi yan. So, the water supply pipe shown daw, hindi pinakita yung problem sa actual exam, so ikaw talaga yung magdodraw. The length of the pipe is supported by the cable, which is 40 meters yung length ng pipe. The total weight of the pipe filled with water is 20 kN per m. So parang ito yung figure natin. Symmetrical cable lang siya. May hinge dyan, saka dito rin. And then meron siyang pipe na dinadala. Yan. And then yung weight naman niya is 20 kN per m. Yan. So merong hangers diyan. For a while. Parang ganyan. So, the first question is, ano daw yung maximum sag at the lowest point of the cable which occurs at mid-length if the allowable tensile load in the cable is 300 kN? Now, fortunately, symmetrical lang yung figure natin. So, we can just cut sa middle point and then, ikaw na yung bahala whether right or left yung ika-consider mo na section. So, slice natin yan. Yan. And then, maglalabasan na yung internal forces natin. So, ito. Now, 40 meters daw yung length ng pipe. So, 40 pala to. Yan, yung pipe natin. So, half of that is 20. Yan. And then, yung maximum tension natin, again, dyan sa support. So, meron tayong, sabihin natin, T-max. Yan. So, T-max is just, yung nag-a-act lang dito are the following. Yung total load, bale, W, the uniform load, multiplied by a distance of 20 meters. And also, the tension at the lowest point, which is FH. Yan. So, our first equation would be, we can take moments about A. Yan. Ito yung point A. So, we have FH. Yan, multiplied by the sag. So, sabihin natin ito. Distance H. Moment arm ng FH patungo sa support. So, FH times H equal yan sa moment na makukos ng load natin. So, W times 20 multiplied by 10. Kasi half kasi yung distance niyan. 10 meters. So, we have this equation. Therefore, ano yung tanong dito? Maximum sag daw. So, H yung hinahanap natin. Now, we can divide yung dalawang sides by H. So, magiging W times 20 times 10 divided by H. Yan. And then, diba, T max is just the hypotenuse of these forces, FH and the total weight. So, Tmax pala is 3,000 daw. So, 3,000 equals square root of FH squared plus W times L squared. So now we have 300 equals square root of FH, palitan natin, W times 20 times 10 divided by H, and then square natin plus W times L is 20. Again, yung half lang yung i-consider natin. And then square. Square natin. Now, W is 20 kN per m. Yan. So, palitan natin yan lahat. Pinakita ko lang. Yan. Gawin natin 20. Input natin, 3,000 equals square root of 20 times 20 times 10 divided by H squared, and then plus 20 times 20 squared. So, yung guess value natin must be malapit lang sa choices. So, 1, 2, 3. Yung middle niya, nasa 2. So, lagay natin 2. So, X pala is 1.345. Yan. So, we have letter D. Now, for the second question naman, we can still consider the same figure, but iba na lang yung hinahanap. So, if the sag of the cable daw at mid-length is 3.5 and the allowable tensile load in the cable is 1,800 kN, how much additional load can the cable carry in kN per m? So, sa pangalawang question, ito na yung nangyara. Instead of 20 kN per m, meron daw additional load. So, bala, parang 20 plus W additional yung ano natin, magnitude ng uniform load. So, ito lang essentially yung nagbago. And then, yung iba din is binigay yung sag. Kasi ito na yung ano natin. Yan. So, still the same process. We have FH. Yan, parang ito lang. But yung H is already given. 3.5 daw. Yan yung sag ng cable. Equals W will become 20 plus W additional. So, 20 plus W add multiplied by 20 multiplied by 10. Now, hindi yan magbabago kasi yan yung distances. Constant lang yan. So, we can define FH pala as this value. Yan. Divided by 3.5. Yan. So, solution natin will be, saan ba? Dito na lang. So, 1,800 daw yung ano natin, maximum tensile load. So, equal yan to square root of FH squared plus W times L squared. So, FH natin itong expression na to. So, medyo mahaba. Yan. And then don't forget na dapat i-square yung buong expression talaga. And then plus natin yung weight. So the weight is now, I mean total weight pala, resultant. So 20 plus W additional, multiply natin by a distance of 20. Yan, so parenthesis pa rin, and then square the whole expression. Yan, so input natin, baguhin na lang natin yung previous equation. So this will now be 1,800, and then ito naman 20 plus the additional load, and then retain lang yan. This is now 3.5, and then 20 plus eto, lagyan mo ng parenthesis. So 20 plus the additional load. Yan. So sa problems na to, if connected yung mga problems sa parabolic cables, huwag mo munang i-exit yung calculator. Kasi pwede mo lang palitan yung values. So shift solve. The additional load pala is 9.73. Yan. So letter D pala. Now sa last question naman, if the sag of the cable at mid length is 4 meters, find the maximum axial stress if the cable diameter is 75 millimeters. So ito madali lang kasi given na lahat. Given na yung sag ng cable sa mid-length. So, ito, hindi na yan unknown. Tanggalin natin yung x, and then this is now 4 meters. Saka ito rin. So, press equals. Tanggalin natin. Yan. 1,077 yung FH. Wait na. 20 times 20. Then 20 times 20 times 10 over 4. And then naka-square. Tama. Ito na yung resultant natin. So, ano ba? Ito na lang. Balitan natin ng 4. So, ito na yung T-max. Which is 1077 kilonewtons. So yung stress pala ng cable would be force over area, where the force is the maximum tension. So 1077. Now kN yan, so kailangan natin convert into newtons. So times 1000, and then divide natin by the area of the cable, which is pi over 4 times 75 squared. Yan, so solve natin, answer na lang, times 1000 divided by pi over 4 times 75 squared. So 243.79 pala. And this is MPA. Yan. So, we have letter B.